This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue Extension Forester, and this is a Woodland Management Moment. In this Woodland Management Moment, we're going to talk about the process of invasive species control in forest areas. And it is a process. There is no one treatment that we can take care of within a season or with one treatment that's going to fully control most of our invasive species. And so we've got a schedule of activities that we've got to work with to get those species under control. This site's a good example. This site was treated with a large mulcher attached to a skid steer loader. The mulcher grinds up the undesirable plants, putting them as mulch down on the ground, opening up the understory of the stand to make it much easier to access and provide for natural regeneration. This area looked much like the dense green we see off in the distance, just chock full with Asian bush honeysuckle that was well over our heads. Very difficult to control with anything other than mechanical approaches. And so that mulcher does a great job. However, what we notice is we still see some green in the understory here. We've got residual Asian bush honeysuckle. And it's from a couple of different sources. So we have plants that were sitting too close to existing trees we did not want to damage, and so we couldn't essentially grind those up without doing damage to the trees we wanted to continue to grow. We also have new seedlings and sprouts from existing root systems. And so that grinder is taking the top off the plants, but not killing the root system. And so we expect we will see some resprouting. And in fact, that's exactly what we've got. The good news is that we've greatly reduced both the number and the size of the invasive species on this area. And so our next treatment will typically be a growing season foliar treatment of a herbicide to coat the foliage of the undesirable Asian bush honeysuckle, killing as many of those stems as we possibly can. And we'll typically do that over 2 or 3 treatment years to really mop up those remaining plants. Once we've reduced those Asian bush honeysuckle, our native species have an opportunity and space to grow and regenerate and return this woodland back to a healthy condition. But we're still not done over the long term. The fact is that many properties do not control Asian bush honeysuckle and other invasives, and so they're a seed source where birds, wind, and water can all scatter seeds of invasive species onto our property. And so we're constantly monitoring, managing, and treating to make sure that we don't have our sites overtaken by invasive species again.